Welcome to your first class using the flipped classroom. Today we're going to learn about simultaneous equation. The objective is to solve a system of two linear equations using the substitution or the elimination method. Let's start by using the substitution method. We want to solve the system of equation 2x plus y equal 13 and 3x plus 2y equal negative 5.
The first step is to pick an equation and make y the subject.
To make y the subject means we rewrite the equation as y equal 13 minus 2x. Once we've done that, we can substitute this y into the second equation. The second equation becomes 3x plus 2 times the expression we found in the first step, which is 13 minus 2x.
We can now simplify and solve this equation. Once we find the value of x, we can substitute this value into the first expression of y. Y equal 13 minus 2x.
In that case, x is 31, so y equal 13 minus 2 times 31. Finally, we can write the solution as x equal 31 and y equal negative 49, or we can write it as a pair of coordinates, xy equal 31 and negative 49. Let's see the elimination method. Before we start the elimination method, we need to think about the variable that we have, but we also need to think about the coefficient in front of the variable. If we look at the y on the first equation, the variable is y, its coefficient is 2. On the second equation, the variable is also y, but the coefficient is 1. What we want is to have a variable in both equations to have the same coefficient with opposite sign. What that means is, for example, I will take the first equation that I will call 1 and I will multiply it by the coefficient negative 3. If I do that, I end up with the equation negative 3x minus 6y equal negative 12. On my first equation, I now have the coefficient negative 3 for the variable x, and on the second equation, I have the coefficient plus 3 for the variable x. My second step is to now add the first equation with the second equation. So if I add them together, I have negative 3x minus 6y equal negative 12 plus 3x plus y equals 7. Finally, I can substitute the value of y that I found into any of the two equations to find the value of x.
We find x equal 2 and we can now write the solution x equal 2 and y equal 1.
Here's another example. Pause the video, try to solve this example, and then check the solution afterward.
Now do this practice problem before the class tomorrow.
It wastes less time to explain things in a class, and you have more time to practice some questions in a class and revise and review some stuff that you're still curious or confused about and ask your teacher.
When you have flipped classroom, the teacher assigns you homework on the video, right? So when you do the video, you do the homework and you watch the video and you come back to class tomorrow or the day you have the next subject about math again, you can have more time with the teacher. So you, per se, you have a question about the homework on the video, you can ask the teacher. Or you, when you have even more questions, you have more time, right, in class, because there's already videos online for you.
The group classroom actually have like three advantages. Like, first of all, you will have less homework once you will watch the videos at home, and you can also use the times effectively, which is the second reason that I think is very help you like studying in class and at home. And the third one is you can rewatch and recap the videos that you have watched like before the exams or before the quiz or the test. And in the classroom, you can ask teachers the questions. That is the reason the flipped classroom is really benefits for you.